One of my favorite experiences of all time was climbing to the second highest peak in the state of New York and gazing across the wide Adirondacks. It was literally awesome. But what is it about awe, and why do we get that feeling? Hey Wanderers, Julia here for DNews. When was the last time you felt awe? Standing under a canopy of soaring sequoias, staring across the vast and endless sea, or looking into the eyes of a newborn? Awe is something that makes us feel connected, part of something larger than ourselves that maybe we can't quite understand. And for us, that's sometimes really difficult. We like ourselves, that big, important I. We like me over we. But we need to get over that real fast, because awe is, well, awesome. But why? Why did we ever evolve this feeling? Maybe to help other people, so say some researchers. So what happens when we experience awe? Well, for one, it might make us healthier. In one study published in the journal Emotion, researchers found that awe reduces the levels of pro-inflammatory proteins called cytokines. These proteins tell the immune system to work harder, which can cause prolonged inflammation, which can cause all sorts of issues like heart damage, diabetes, Alzheimer's, and even depression. Which, of course, depression might lead people to be less likely to explore and seek out awe. So the researchers aren't sure which came first, the low cytokines or the positive emotions. My bet is on the positive emotions, because other studies like one published in the journal Psychological Science found that awe might make us prefer experiences over things and even be happier with our lives. Awe can even change a person's perception of time. After being awestruck, some people felt like they have more time, according to that study published in the journal Psychological Science. In this study, students watched a commercial designed to invoke awe, which had stuff like whales and waterfalls in it. Afterwards, the students filled out a questionnaire in which they responded positively to questions like, I have lots of time in which I can get things done, and they were more likely to use their time to help other people. Seriously, awe can make us be more generous to other people. Another study published in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology says the experience of awe makes us more willing to help someone else. In several studies, people who thought about the last time they felt awe or watched awe-inspiring nature videos showed more ethical behavior than people who thought about other positive feelings like pride. In one particularly clever setup, researchers had participants either stand, gazing up at tall eucalyptus trees for a full minute, or stand in a similar spot but looking at a building instead. After the minute was up, the researchers accidentally dropped a box of pens. Those who were looking up at the awe-inspiring trees were much more likely to help the researcher than those in the control setting. So why does awe make us more helpful? Well, because big things make us feel small, and that's a good thing. The researchers think that by feeling smaller, our focus shifts away from ourselves and towards the greater good. So want to feel happier and more helpful? Head out to the woods! Or if you'd prefer to stay inside and still want to experience awe, Jason Silva explores the idea in one of his first video on his show, Shots of Awe.
There's a great book called The Wondering Brain that says that one of the ways that we elicit wonder is by scrambling the self temporarily so that the world can seep in.
Make sure to check out his show and subscribe to his channel. There's a link to subscribe in the description of this video. So what's the last awesome experience you had? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.